In this video, we're going to continue with our SSIS package, and we're going to deploy it to a SQL Server. If you haven't seen the previous video where we create this SSIS package, you should pause this video and watch that one first. So in deploying the project, the first thing you need to make sure is that you've installed SSIS on your SQL Server. There are a few different ways to do this, and if you'd like instructions on them, you should contact Microsoft or find their documentation. For example, this Microsoft document describes different ways to install integration services. The way that we chose for these VMs is listed here. On the Features selection page under Shared Features, select Integration Services. This is done during the installation or the addition of features on the SQL Server installation wizard. Once that's done, you should see under Services, SQL Server Integration Services. Make sure this is installed and that it's running. In the previous video, we confirmed that this data flow is working, so we'll go ahead and deploy it now. We'll go to Project, Deploy, and we'll click through the wizard. We'll put in our SQL Server, and we'll browse for a path, but we see that an integration services catalog, SSISDB, was not found on this server. To deploy a project to the server, we have to create this one first. So from the integration services catalogs node, we should create a catalog. Under Integration Services Catalog, we'll right-click Create Catalog. Type in a password and click OK. Now we see SSISDB has been created. We'll go back to Visual Studio and retry on the deployment. You see this one, so we'll create a new folder underneath it, New Green Equipment Export, and click OK. We'll click Next and deploy. We'll click Close, and now we're done with Visual Studio. Everything up to this point was the development phase, and now that we've created our SSIS package and deployed it to a SQL Server, everything else can be done from the SQL Server itself. So we'll close this out, and we'll refresh this catalog. We'll expand through to the projects in the packages, and we'll right-click on this package and execute, and then click OK. The operation has started, so we can look at the overview page if we want. Here we see the current status is running. We've given it a little bit of time, so let's go ahead and refresh. Here we see the status has changed to succeeded. We can confirm this by looking at our tag that we created to track the progress. To open up the SQL file we created a few videos ago, we'll have the name of the link server. Here we see the success message from a few minutes ago when we just ran this package. From this point forward, in order to run this package, all we need to do is open up SSMS, connect to the SQL Server, drill down, and execute the package. However, if you want this package to run every day, you can do this using the SQL Server agent. Let's start by running the SQL Server agent service. SSMS, we should see that the SQL Server agent is now showing a green arrow. Now, let's right-click, New Job. We'll name this New Green Data Export Daily Job. Under Steps, we'll click New. Run SSIS package, SQL Server Integration Services package, run as SQL Server Agent Service Account, and we'll navigate to find the package itself. One thing of note here is that we're running as the SQL Server Agent Service Account. This means that we need permission for that account to access all the data that we need on this AF server, as well as writing to the tag and the Pi server. To find out what account this is, open up Services and navigate to the SQL Server Agent Service. Under Log On As, you can see what the account is. Make sure this account has the appropriate permissions. We'll click OK, and we'll click on Schedules. We'll add a new schedule and name it Daily Schedule. We'll set it to run in a few minutes, starting today. Everything else should be good, so we'll click OK. And I'll skip ahead to when this has already reached the trigger. We'll click on Job Activity Monitor and confirm that this is starting when it's supposed to. It's past the time, so let's go ahead and refresh and see that it worked. When we hit refresh, we see last run outcome succeeded, last run 6:50 p.m. And for final confirmation, we can look at the tracker tag that we created earlier. Let's refresh this query and see the new success message. Now that this SSIS package is deployed, confirmed to be working outside of Visual Studio, and scheduled to work as a scheduled task every day, this concludes the video. Thanks for watching.